Final cross-examination on behalf of the panel.
I would be very glad to answer.
Mr. Ventilacion.
Yes.
The Bible says in 2 Peter chapter 3, verse 16,
okay.
It says, speaking of this, as he does in all his letters, there are some things in them hard to understand, which the ignorant and unstable twist to their own destruction, as they do the other scriptures. St. Peter warns us that there are people that will take the Bible and twist it.
Correct.
Iglesia de Cristo stands virtually alone, along with the Jehovah's Witnesses and Mormons, and the United Pentecostal Church. You virtually stand alone. 99% of Christianity, Orthodox, Protestants, mainline Protestants, and Catholics believe that God is a holy trinity. Based on scripture passages, my question is it possible that Iglesia ni Cristo may take some scripture out of context, or is Iglesia ni Cristo infallible?
All right, very good question.
1 minute answer.
The reason why the Catholics and the Protestants are almost the same in their teaching of who is God, and they would say three persons in one God, because these doctrines or teachings were started to be taught by the Catholic Church in the 4th century through the Council of Nicaea and the Council of Constantinople, but that is not what Christ and the apostles said. There is only one church. It should stand out among the many. We are the Church of Christ of the Bible.
Since you haven't answered this in the whole time you've been here, question, did Jesus give Peter the keys, yes or no?
He was given the key, but I did not read in the verse that Apostle Peter is being made as the Pope. In fact, Christ told him in Matthew chapter 23, verse 9, do not call any man your papa.
Why is it that St. Matthew, the same apostle that writes in Matthew 23, 9, to the Pharisees in context, because they were trying to lord over the people, why does Matthew, if you say you can't use the word father to call anybody else, in the genealogy of Jesus Christ in Matthew chapter 1, he goes on and he says, Abraham is the father of Isaac. Isaac is the father of Jacob. Jacob is the father of Israel. And he goes on for 2 pages. Is Matthew contradicting himself?
I like it.
2 minutes.
Okay. The fatherhood there is about the race. The fatherhood that Jesus said in Matthew 23:9 is about being a spiritual father. And the talking about the fatherhood in the flesh. No, he is referring to being a spiritual father, and that's your Pope and a priest.
In the book of Isaiah chapter 51, Isaiah calls Abraham father. In Romans chapter 5, St. Paul calls Abraham father. In Luke chapter 16, Jesus calls Abraham father. They don't have a problem using the word father, you do.
No, no.
1 minute.
Here's the answer. We don't have a problem. Abraham is called father. But he was never called a spiritual father. Your priests and your popes said that they are spiritual fathers. In Hebrews 12 and 9, I'll be patient. It says here, in the case of our human fathers, they punish us and we respect them. How much more then should we submit to our spiritual father and live? God is the spiritual father.
that's your entire position. Read it. It says, we share in Christ. 1 Corinthians 12:27.